How do you feel?
I'm Phil.
Good.
I'm very Phil.
How you feel?
I'm Phil. I'm very Phil.
How do you feel?
I'm Phil. I'm very Phil.
You feel?
Yes, I'm Phil. I'm very, very Phil.
Welcome back, heroes and adventurers, shield maidens and barbarians. I am the Ancient Gamer, and in this video, we're going to talk a little bit about modding Skyrim on Xbox consoles. Mainly, we're going to talk about load orders, because the load order, your list of mods, and the order in which they load into the game, is the basic foundation of a stable and healthy modded Skyrim experience. It all starts with the load order, and when it comes to game performance and crashing, mods that don't work like they should, it often all comes back to the load order. This is why nothing causes Skyrim modders to sweat bullets like their load order. Where should I put this mod? Above Xmod or below Ymod? A lot of us have agonized over quandaries like this. But it doesn't have to be like this. Modding Skyrim is a lot of fun, and playing your finished creation one of the most rewarding and satisfying experiences in all of gaming. You don't need to get the load order blues every time you think about adding a new mod. In this video, I'm going to do my best to break down the process and make it as simple as it actually is. The first rule of modding Skyrim and building a load order is, don't make this shit any harder than it is. I'm going to give you some tips and tricks, a couple of suggestions, a few basic rules to follow, and a really cool fucking tool to help you avoid overthinking it and ending up with the load order blues. By the end of this video, you should have all the confidence and know-how you need to build a healthy, stable load order and make Skyrim your own. Hey, if you find this video helpful, informative, do it a favor and give it a like. That makes the video feel good. Subscribe to my channel. That makes you feel good. Ring the bell for notifications. That feels good too. The first step to building a solid, stable load order is to figure out which mods you want. Maybe you're using one of my load orders and want to make it your own and add mods to it. Once you've decided on the mods you want to use, the tool I'm going to give you will show you where to put them and how they should be arranged. Now, it's important to remember when you're picking out mods that you just can't have everything. There is no way to load up every cool mod you see and still have a healthy, smooth-running Skyrim, particularly on consoles. Of course, there is the 5GB reserve space cap, but even before you bump up against that, it's just a reality that the more mods you add to your game, eventually the slower it's going to start to run. As a matter of fact, it's been proven that due to a bug or poor implementation in Skyrim's engine, if you have more than a few dozen mods, it will start to negatively impact your frame rate and performance. This was tested using empty dummy mods with no masters. Even 150 mods, less than a kilobyte each, that do absolutely nothing, can really make your game chug. On PC, there is a mod that fixes this, SSE Fixes, but it's an SKSE64 dependent mod that will almost certainly never be available on console. If you've watched my other modding videos, you know that you don't need 150 mods or even 100 mods to have a great looking, great running version of Skyrim. Your game will be happiest running 30 to 50 mods, but it'll still thank you for running only 60 to 75. It'll thank you by loading quickly, running smooth, and not crashing. Another important tip is to always do your homework. If you're looking at a mod, thinking about putting it in your game, read that mod's description thoroughly. Here's a pro tip for you. Even though you're modding Skyrim on an Xbox, don't be afraid to go to the Nexus and find the same mod for PC over there. Usually, you'll find an even more detailed description. Scroll over to the Post tab and check out the comments too. That's where you can see what other people who have used the mod have to say about it, any issues they may have or may have not had, and what they did to fix them. Often the mod author will respond with even more insight. So, let's get to the tool itself. I call it the Ultimate Modular Load Order Framework. The basic idea is that instead of having one large, long load order, which can be hard as hell to wrap your mind and eyes around, you have 9 smaller, independent load orders, or modules. Each module can and should be worked on separately of the others. If you look a little closer, the Modular Load Order Framework has been designed to work that way. That's because this tool has been organized around overwrites. What's an overwrite? It's important to understand overwriting, what it is and how to make it work for you. In a nutshell, when you start up Skyrim, the mods you've installed will load from the top down to the bottom. If 2 mods alter the same thing, the mod that's lower or installed last will overwrite the one above it and win the conflict. A good example is Divine SMIM and the High Poly project. There's a few files both mods edit. I personally prefer the looks of High Poly, so I load it underneath Divine SMIM. Both mods work great, but where they overlap, High Poly overwrites and I get that mesh in the game. The way my Modular Load Order Framework works is that the mods in each section may overwrite parts of each other, but mods from Section 5 are unlikely to overwrite mods from the modules above or below it. This makes life a lot easier as it's much more manageable to work on a set of 6 to 10 mods than it is to keep track of 50 to 70 all at once. Let's take a deeper dive into the Modular Load Order Framework, exactly how it works and why it works so well. How you want to look at it is that each one of these modules is like its own little tiny load order. I've organized the mods by category and type and then arranged them in the order that they should load into each module. The way I've listed the categories in each module is the load order for that module. At the same time, the modules themselves are also arranged in the order that the group of mods best loads into your game. Think about it as a group of smaller load orders within a greater, larger load order framework, thus the name Modular Load Order Framework. Module 1 is for fundamental game and engine altering mods. Really, this is USSEP we're talking about. The patch is a master file. It needs to go on the very top. Also, settings are .any mods like less grass or field of view mods. The way Skyrim loads up from start, the first thing it does is run the settings, so you want them up high, just under the patch, so that every mod loaded below gets the word that the settings have changed. Module 2 contains mods that alter magic and enchanting systems. Now imagine that you are a perk mod, and you just want to do your part. It really helps you out to know about any changes made to the magic and enchanting systems. Taking your seat just below them is a good way to be a happy little perk mod. See how this works? Now we get to the graphics module, what I call the Bob Ross module, in the load order. This is always the most popular section, as you can see right away the effect your mods have. Graphics mods are also the mods that overwrite each other most often. So this is a great place for us to check out overwrites in action. Using graphics mods on console is all about layering. Layering is all about the overwrite. The way it works is you want to start with the bigger landscape mods that are underneath everything else, then paint in pretty little layers of detail out into the foreground. Work from the background to the foreground, from the bigger mods to the smaller detail mods, letting those smaller ones overwrite the little details in the bigger ones. And then you end up with some really happy little trees, and some happy bigger trees too. Here we have the Skyland layer down, and we're just going to paint out another nice little layer here, and then bring in the soft, lush grass and those happy, healthy, fuller trees. And one more time. Vanilla Skyrim. Looking beautiful, but it could be better, it could be happier. So we layer in the Skyland landscape mod, and now we're going to bring in the clean, cool water and that soft, healthy grass. And there we have it. Happy little grass, happy little trees. Do you want to change the look of your game? Just, in essence, pull out the graphics module, empty it, install a new set of graphics mods and slide it back in. Do a full restart and voila, you're done. It's as simple as that. While it is always a risk to pull mods out of an existing playthrough and pop in new ones, in general, graphics and texture mods tend to cooperate with being switched out more than other types of mods. Usually, it will work out okay. Module 4 is your places section. Towns, villages, new areas, player homes, and maps all go here. Towns and places are larger than player homes, so put them on top. Maps need to be aware of everything that is supposed to be on them, so put them on the bottom. The people and creatures section is module number 5. NPCs and followers are often, but not always, dependent on your body and beauty mods to look pretty. Put them on top so the body and beauty mods can overwrite. Any kind of custom skeleton will always go below the skin deep mods. Idols and animations often depend on a skeleton mod, so always put them last in this module. A quick word on followers. Follower mods are great. You gotta give your Dragonborn a friend. I'm a big believer, everyone needs a friend. Plus, followers make Skyrim feel less lonely. Maybe you'll want to use a few standalone friends and a follower management mod like Amazing Follower Tweaks to have more options and to be able to have more than one follower at a time. But you also want to use a custom voice follower like Inigo or Sophia. Standalone followers use the vanilla Skyrim follower AI system, and Amazing Follower Tweaks is designed to work with that. But custom voice companions typically have their own AI and behavior systems. If you use AFT on them, your custom companions can quickly develop some serious mental health issues. To get around this, load standalone followers, then AFT, then followers like Inigo, Sophia, Caden, below that. This keeps all your friends happy and healthy. Module 6 is your stuff section. Clothing, armor, weapons, gear, stuff. With this module, the order that you load things doesn't matter much. You can put weapons on the bottom and clothing on top. Doesn't matter. The important thing is that all this stuff is grouped together. Module 7 is gameplay tweaks, systems mods, and crafting. Mods like Rich Merchants, Ars Metallica, and More Kill Moves go here. The very bottom of this module is where you put alternate start. If you use Cheat Room, it goes on top of module number 8. Below that are any AI or dialogue and conversation mods. These need to be at the very bottom of your load order for the conversation and dialogue to trigger correctly. Finally, module 9 is for patches. Patches are the unsung heroes of modding Skyrim on Xbox. They aren't very exciting, and they don't get a lot of love. Technically, they aren't even really mods, but they are super important. Sometimes, two popular mods just won't play nicely together. When that happens, a mod author may make a compatibility patch to make each mod happy again. Patches have to load below any mods they are patching, so the best way to handle them is to put them below everything else. One more pro tip. The canary in the coal mine when modding Skyrim on Xbox consoles is slower load times. If you notice that fast travel, going in and out of buildings, or loading into the game from a save is taking noticeably longer, that's a sign that your game is starting to become unhappy. Either you are pushing too many mods, or some of them are in the wrong places. By the time you have a Skyrim that crashes at doorways or on fast travel, you should have already noticed that load times have gotten slower. So that's it. That's how the Modular Load Order Framework works. The mods in each section may interact with each other, but for the most part, they do not interact substantially with mods in other modules. If you change a mod or add one to Section 7, you shouldn't need to make any changes to the order of the mods in Section 3 to make it all work. Work on each section separately. Hopefully, I've pulled back the curtain a little bit and showed you just how easy and fun modding Skyrim can be. There are lots of Skyrim YouTubers out there who might do it different than me, and that's fine. Many of them are really good at what they do. But I've modded Skyrim on PC and Xbox for years, and this is how I do it. In the meantime, don't sweat the small stuff. You don't need to remember every detail we just talked about. You have the tool. You can just use that, and you're going to be okay. Remember, Skyrim is your own world. You can do what you want with it. Make it your own and have fun. Don't forget to smile. Once again, I am the Ancient Gamer, and I'm absolutely thrilled that you watch my video. Do it a big favor and click that like button. It's easy, and it really helps. Looking for more of a long-term commitment? Subscribe to the Ancient Gamer channel. It feels good. Ring the bell for notifications. That feels good too. Stay tuned. I'll be back soon with more stuff.